The G4KL is the Tata family engine that has been produced since 2017. It's used in Kia Stinger and also in the Genesis G70 and G80 models. For now, it's only used in the Genesis G70, other applications were discontinued in 2023. This is a pretty powerful engine with direct injection. It produces 250 to 255 horsepower and up to 260 pound-feet of torque, having only 4 cylinders. Also, the G4KL engine is only used in rear-wheel drive cars, while the G4KH is its technical twin, and this one is used for a wider range of Kia and Hyundai vehicles. The engine has the timing chain inside, which is more or less reliable. Both camshafts are equipped with phasers for efficiency, and there is a Garrett turbocharger for more power. The engine is not perfect in terms of fuel economy or longevity because it was initially made for active driving and its task is to provide owners with perfect acceleration and top speed. So when it comes to the problems, we have a lot of things to discuss. First of all, the high-pressure fuel pump in these engines appeared to be really faulty, and there are a lot of cases when it required replacement way before the warranty period ended. One of the clear symptoms is fuel leak into the cylinders, so you will have a sharp oil level increase. Don't drive your car in this case, have the pump replaced and also change the oil and oil filter after that. Also, the direct injection system causes carbon buildup on intake valves, but given the engine is usually driven pretty aggressively, this problem will bother you only at high mileage. One more issue is that the engine doesn't have hydraulic lifters, and you will have to pay for valve adjustment about once every 60,000 miles or 100,000 kilometers. There are cases when these engines had rod bearing issues at low mileage and required replacement. The reason for this is the oil starvation, low oil pressure. I strongly recommend cutting the recommended oil change interval in half and changing oil every 5,000 miles or 8,000 kilometers. This will save you from balance shafts problems and rod bearings failure. Also, I would only use OEM oil and filters for this engine. Like in almost every other chain-driven Hyundai engine, the chain here is not eternal. I would strongly recommend checking it at about 120,000 kilometers or 75,000 miles. If the engine is driven aggressively, the chain will require replacement at this mileage. If it jumps, the engine is dead. Other than that, this engine is pretty good and only bothers you with some minor problems and leaks that are easily repaired, but the overall life expectancy of the engine is not perfect. Experts usually expect these engines to last up to 250,000 kilometers or 150,000 miles. Of course, perfect oil service and attention to minor problems will prolong the life of the engine significantly.